God for just a moment. You know, Moses, he asked God when the Lord told him to lead the Israelites out. And he said, what if they don't believe me? What if they don't believe that you're the one that has sent me? Abraham, he asked about the servant. He said, about Isaac's future wife. He said, what if the young woman refuses to come with me? Joseph's brother asked the question. What if Joseph bears a grudge against us? And all of them wondered about the circumstances. And what if something was just not going to work out like they felt like God had laid on their life? There's so many staggering questions today. What is, when are we going to be able to go back to work? When is the hospitals going to be able to do the things that they want to do? I work at the funeral home. I get the questions every day. When, what if, and what if we don't ever go back to normal? We even have the questions, what is the new normal? What if my child dies? What are we going to do? What if my mother or father goes in the hospital and won't ever get to see them again? This past week, I had one of my mother's sisters went into the hospital. She had contacted the coronavirus, and we were all very afraid that she would never come out of the hospital. We thought we'd never see her again. But the what if has got a good ending to that story. She was able to go back, and she's back in the nursing home. We can't see her there, but she's able to do well, and she's we're able to see her through a window, slip outside, and we get to also Facebook Live and get to see her thanks to a good nurse there. So some of our what ifs get answered. The uncomfortable truth is this. Any of those things are worst nightmares could possibly happen. It happens to people every day. No one is free from tragedy. No one is free from pain. There's no guarantees of an easy life. There's no guarantees of even tomorrow. I was thinking as I was preparing for tonight of an old song, Take This Whole World But Give Me Jesus. So the what ifs get answered in some of those old songs. No turning back is the answer. We have to put in our own life. Sometimes I have to reluctantly admit to myself that my desire to be faithful when I was young, as a young Christian, was rooted thinking that if I give, God gives back. I was expecting a payback because we know that God is a giving God. But the truth is, God don't owe us anything. He's given us the hope of eternal life. So I really don't want to love God expecting something back. I want to love God not for what he can do for me, but I want to love God because I want to worship him because he's worthy. In the Bible, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, they were not guaranteed deliverance, but I like what they said. If we're thrown into that burning blaze, if we're thrown into that fire, the God we serve is able to deliver us. But if he doesn't, we want you to know we will not serve your gods. And they wouldn't bend, they wouldn't bow, they wouldn't burn, as the old song says. So we're not moving from the thought of what if. I want to go to the even if. Even if I get sick tomorrow. Even if I wake up tomorrow morning with a bad fever. Even if I go and I have a test run and it says, Billy Byrd, you have the coronavirus that's raging in your body, I'm going to serve him anyhow. If I lose every dime that I have, I'm going to serve him anyhow. If I lose my job, if they tell me that I don't have a job for tomorrow, I'm going to serve him anyhow. It's even if. God's grace is sufficient. We see that even if the worst happens, God will carry us. He's still good. He's still God. And he will never leave us nor forsake us. So I want to just close with tonight just a short word of prayer. And I want you to move from your thought of what if to an even if. Even if. Even if we can't have church. Even if we can't be well in our body, we're going to serve the Lord. Would you bow your heads? Thank you, Father God, for this thought in our minds tonight that you've given us everything that we need. You've given us your grace. You've given us, Lord, the blessed hope of your soon return. You've given us a heaven to gain and a hell to shun. We give you praise tonight, and we thank you. We'll serve you even if the whole world goes against the things that we know is correct and we know is true. We're going to serve you. We give you praise tonight. In Jesus' wonderful name, amen. Want to be able to see everyone Sunday. Want to encourage everyone. Looks like this thing's about to be over with. So even if it don't, we're going to come on to church anyhow. We have to have it in the parking lot. God bless you. Good to be with you this evening.